The Blue Network presents the international star of stage and screen, the mastery of mystery, Boris Karloff, in Creep by Night. How do you do? This is Boris Karloff joining with you once again for another exploration into the unknown darkness of the human mind. Tonight, our story illustrates in terrifying terms the oft-repeated theme of this program. There is no mystery greater than the mystery of the mind. It is for you to decide whether these weird and ghastly happenings were a figment of man's imagination or a tragic reality beyond man's understanding. Creep by Night presents Boris Karloff as Loomis Horton in The Hunt. Our scene is the Horton farm, 50 acres of rich grazing pasture almost on the edge of the Louisiana bayous. The legendary swampland that for centuries was the spawning ground of black magic and voodoo. The night is warm and dark, with heavy silence broken only by the hum of insects, the chirping of crickets, and the occasional deep-throated croak of a bullfrog off in the swamp. Suddenly, the shadowed outline of a human figure appears at the edge of a cypress grove behind the weather-beaten Horton house, and a soft, whistled signal rides the still night air. For a long moment, there is no response. Then, a door at the rear of the house opens quietly, and a girl crosses to the cypress grove, her eyes searching the darkness.
Jeff?
Right here, Julie.
Jeff, you shouldn't have come. He's in one of his black moods tonight. I gotta go right back in. He'll kill me if he finds me here.
He won't kill nobody. I'm getting fed up with him ruining your life, Julie. Got a mind to tell him a thing or two.
It won't do any good, Jeff.
What rights he got keeping you from getting some fun out of living? That's what I want to know.
He's my brother.
That don't give him no right to pen you up. You ain't one of his stinking sheep.
Jeff, please, not so loud. He'll hear you.
I don't much care if he does.
See, Jeff, I'll be the one to suffer.
Oh, I'm sorry, Julie. Only makes me mad clean through when I think of him treating you the way he does. I want to marry you, Julie, and take you away from here. The story's going around the village.
What do you mean, Jeff?
I don't like to say it, Julie, but the folks are talking about your brother, Loomis.
Talking? I don't understand.
Well, Bert Peavely and Bill Mason come through here Nightfall last hunting coon. Said they saw Loomis out in the east pasture, digging a grave.
A grave?
Yeah. He's burying something. You know what it was, Julie? Got any idea?
No. I don't, Jeff.
But what?
Oh, I shouldn't be telling you this, Jeff.
It won't go no further, Julie.
Promise.
Hope to die.
Well, I heard Loomis talking with the hired man. I heard him say something comes out of the swamp at night.
Out of the swamp?
Yes. They don't know what it is. But come dark, Loomis hardly never goes without his shotgun.
Sound like voodoo to me, Julie. I gotta take you away from here. It ain't healthy.
Oh, you can't, Jeff. Not till I'm 18. Not for 2 months yet.
How am I gonna sit around for 2 months thinking about you shut up in a house with that crazy man?
You got no right to say that, Jeff.
I got every right. Digging graves at night. Burying Lord knows what and talking about things coming out of the swamp. I ought to say something to him about all this.
You can say it right now.
Oh. Evening, Mr. Horton.
Get back into the house, Julie.
Hold on a minute, Mr. Horton.
Get into the house.
I'm going, Loomis. Bye.
Julie, wait.
Let her go.
You got no right treating her like you do.
I got a right to do as I please. She's my sister and she's underage. Now get off my land and don't come back. If I catch you here again, I'll horsewhip you.
I don't scare easy, Mr. Horton.
No. Perhaps I got something in the house that may change your mind. I'll give you 5 minutes to get off my land.
I'll leave when I'm good and ready, and not before.
I'm going back indoors for a shotgun. And if you're still here when I come out again, you'll get a load of buckshot. Remember that.
There, dirty, low-down skunk. Just let me catch him once off his own land. Just once. I'll beat his ugly head off. What's that? Sound like a wolf. Only there ain't no wolves out here. No. There ain't a wolf crowd. Come on. Come closer. I'm sneaking through the cypress grove. I wonder what it is. Maybe I better...
I'm afraid there's not much I can tell you, Professor Taylor, except that it happened 5 weeks ago. State police moved in on the case right after the boy's body was found. Frankly, we didn't get very far. It's still an unsolved mystery.
I see. You know, of course, why I'm here, Sergeant.
Well, all I know is we had a letter from the State University saying you were coming down to do some research on the case.
Yes, yes, exactly. Now, as I understand it, Sergeant, the boy's throat was considerably lacerated.
Worse than that. There wasn't any throat left.
You're convinced it was an animal?
Well, what else could it be? No human could rip a throat open like that.
Were there any cracks?
No, and the ground was pretty hard. And what stopped us cold was our bloodhound couldn't pick up a trace of scent. No animal scent anyhow.
How about human?
Well, only the Hortons and the hired man, Andrew. They don't count. Thing happened on Horton land, so naturally you'd expect it.
Yes, 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 of course. Tell me, this Horton you mentioned.
Loomis Horton, his name is.
Does he keep a dog? A savage dog?
No, won't allow one on the place. He investigated the dog angle, but there isn't one like that in the whole parish.
Curious. Very curious. Where is the Horton farm located, Sergeant?
About 7 miles out of town. County road.
Did the boy live or work there?
No, no. According to Horton's story, Jeff thought it was calling on young Julie. She's Horton's sister. Jeff left about 9:30, and a few minutes later, Horton heard him screaming for help. Horton ran out the back of the house, found Jeff at the edge of a cypress grove. Stone dead.
Mm-hmm. I'd like a little talk with this Horton, Sergeant.
Well, I don't know. He's a queer duck. Doesn't take much to strangers. And doesn't take much to anybody, as a matter of fact.
Really?
Well, he puts in most of his time looking after his farm and his sheep. Keeps one hired man. Between the two of them, they manage pretty well. Then there's his young sister, the girl Jeff Tuttle was calling on. He doesn't let her out of his sight. Keeps pretty much cooped up in the house. Nice-looking girl, too.
Mm-hmm. Would it be possible to drive out to the Horton farm tonight, Sergeant?
Let's see, 8:10. It'll be dark by the time we get there.
Well, you're not afraid of the dark, are you?
I'm not afraid of anything I can see. Let's go.
Is it much farther, Sergeant?
About a mile. Professor, look at that.
Look at what?
There, ahead, crossing the road. Is that a dog?
Good grief. Speed up, Sergeant. Hurry before it's gone. Look how its eye is gleaming our headlights. A yellow fire.
That dog is the biggest one I ever saw.
I'm afraid it's no dog, Sergeant. Quick, swing to the left. Keep your lights on it. Ah, you notice anything?
Starting to run. Heading for the cypress grove.
Yes, but notice the color, that peculiar gray.
It's gone.
And the fangs, the pointed ears, the way it moved. Didn't it remind you of a wolf?
Let's go after it.
No, wait, Sergeant. No use. Not in this darkness. We'll never find it in that thick grove.
Yes, you're right. You really think it was a wolf?
I said it reminded me of one.
Well, we don't have wolves in this section, Professor.
Yes, I know. Sergeant, I think it's time I told you the kind of research I intend doing. Do you know what lycanthropy is?
No, can't say I do.
Well, it's a form of madness, a disease of the mind. Those who are afflicted with it imagine they've turned into wild animals.
Mm.
They develop a taste for blood and often commit violence when the spasm seizes them. Once the seizure is over, they return to normalcy with no knowledge of what occurred.
Sounds pretty horrible.
Yes, it is horrible. You understand there's no physical change except the deepening of the voice, as far as we know.
What do you mean? far as you know.
Well, some authorities believe the disease may be so deeply rooted in certain human beings that when a spasm seizes them, their actual physical appearance is altered. They take on the form as well as the habits of wild beasts. They're called werewolves. Men who turn into wolves.
What?
Well, what's the matter, Sergeant? Why did you jump?
It, just kind of hit me. Bloodhounds not finding any animal scent, and that gray thing we just saw run across the room.
We mustn't leap to conclusions, Sergeant. No true werewolf has ever been found, although there are many alleged eyewitness accounts claiming that such creatures have been seen, particularly in the Balkan countries of Europe. Thus far, though, we have no positive scientific proof that werewolves really exist.
Hope they don't.
So do I, Sergeant. I devoutly hope so. That's the case of this young man whose throat was torn out, presents some aspects I'd like to investigate.
I'm beginning to see what you're thinking about.
I suggest we drive on to the Horton farm, Sergeant. Doesn't seem to be anyone home.
The light upstairs, out in the parlor. Seldom goes out at night.
How old a man would you say he is?
45, 6. Somebody's coming.
Yes? Who is it?
Sergeant Moran, State Police.
Dr. Roman.
Sounds a little out of breath. Don't be scared when you see him, Professor. He's not too pretty to look at. Sorry to disturb you, Mr. Horton, but...
What do you want?
This is Professor Taylor, State University.
I'm pleased to meet you, Mr. Horton.
Yes. What is it?
May we come in?
I was just going to bed.
We'll be just a few minutes. After you, Professor.
Thank you.
Bess Taylor came down from the university to do a little investigating on Jeff Tuttle's case, Mr. Horton. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Sick and tired of answering questions. I've told you all I know. What more do you want?
You can explain it better than I can, Professor. Go ahead.
Yes, of course. Well, you see, Mr. Horton, my investigation is purely scientific. It has nothing whatsoever to do with the police.
No?
I'm merely trying to determine whether the brutal attack on the young man was made by a human or an animal. Or perhaps a combination of both.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, you've heard of werewolves, haven't you, Mr. Horton?
No, and I'm not interested. I told you I've had enough of questions. Hasn't a man a right to a little privacy?
Well, no need to get sore about it, Horton.
I don't like being questioned. I don't like to have people barging in on me at all hours of the night. This is my house, and I'm going to live in it the way I see fit, which means without uninvited visitors.
Of course, Mr. Horton. It isn't my intention.
And another thing. I own the property from the county road to the bayou and north to Kurt Schultz's pasture. If you took the time to notice, the land's posted. Now, this is a warning. The next person, man, woman, or child, who sets foot on my land is going to get a load of buckshot. Is that clear?
You're in a bad humor tonight, Horton.
Never mind my bad humor. Get out. Both of you. Get out and stay out.
Lopez, what's the matter? Why are you shouting?
Julie! What are you doing in the kitchen? Didn't I tell you to stay up in your room?
But, Lou,
don't how you dare come down that rear stairway when my back's turned.
I just wanted to find out if you'd asked Andrew about my lamb. How many were killed?
Get upstairs to your room or out.
Go and Loomis, don't be angry.
I presume that was your sister, Mr. Horton? Lovely girl.
Good night, gentlemen. Get off my property and don't come back unless you're invited.
Sorry, Professor. Looks like we're being asked to leave.
Oh, it's quite all right. Thank you anyway, Mr. Horton. Perhaps some other evening you'll grant me a few minutes of your time.
Now you know what sort of a job we had with him.
I must say, he isn't very sociable.
Watch the steps. They're not too solid.
Oh, yeah. His sister doesn't resemble him in the least.
Oh, he's rather pretty. You hear how he screamed at
her? Yes. Poor child.
Might as well head back to town, I guess. Horton didn't rise to your bait when you mentioned werewolves, so looks like a hunt will be the next best thing.
A hunt, Sergeant?
Yes. Get a bunch of men together and beat the cypress groves for that animal we saw crossing the road. Might even risk going into the swamp. Wolf or whatever it is, I won't be satisfied unless killed.
I'm afraid I feel the same way, Sergeant. But before you organize a hunt, I wonder if it's safe to do a little snooping around here first.
What is it? Something the girl said disturbed me. Something about lambs being killed.
That's right. She did say she wanted to know if Horton's hired man had told him how many of her lambs were killed.
Yes, and that may be significant. Werewolves are supposedly fond of slaughtering sheep. Do you think we might talk with the hired man?
Chances are he's over in the barn. He's got a room there built out of a horse stall. Take a look.
It might be a good idea.
It's over this way. Keep an eye out for Horton. He may come gunning for us. I don't trust him.
I wouldn't be too concerned. Men who rant and roar are rarely dangerous.
Wait a minute.
Hold up. What is it?
Somebody's hiding behind that bush on your left.
All right. Come up with your hands up or I'll shoot.
Watch it, Sergeant.
Shine your flash on him, Professor.
Yes, certainly. There.
Andrew, hired man.
I ain't done nothing. Honest, I ain't.
Why were you hiding behind that bush?
I got scared. I heard voices in the gravel.
What were you doing out here?
Burying the sheep and the lambs.
What was that? Since when do you bury sheep and lambs?
Well, these got to be. Mr. Holton said so. They run afoul of the critter.
What critter?
Only the Lord knows. We got strange goings on around here. Mighty strange. Always said it was too close to the bayou. Tain't healthy. Them swamps is full of things.
Where are you burying the sheep, Andrew?
Right over there. Put them in the duck garden, Mr. Horton said. Good and deep.
Let's have a look at them, Sergeant.
All right.
See? There they are. Four ewes and two of Miss Julie's baby lambs.
All with their throats torn out.
Yeah. It's the critter from the swamps. Same one got Jeff Tuttle.
When did this happen, Andrew?
The lambs got took night before last. We lost three ewes on Sunday and one last night.
Has it ever happened before?
Been going on most 2 years. Not regular, though. Oh, months will go by and the critter don't show up. Took a shot at him once, it did.
When was this?
Last spring. Seen him behind the pump house. Like to scared me half to death. The way his eyes glowed like a swamp fire. Wasn't time to draw no beads. Missed him, I guess.
What did he look like, Andrew?
Couldn't tell. Too dark. All I seen was his eyes glowing yellow. Might have been a sheep-killing collar, though. One of them wild ones.
I very much doubt it.
You're thinking of what we saw on the road tonight, Professor? That animal, whatever it was.
Yes, if it was an animal.
Why do you say that?
Just look at these dead sheep. See where I'm flashing my light? Their back legs, eh? An ordinary animal would have nipped the legs and torn at their rumps. There's not a mark on them, except at their throats.
Somebody's coming, gravel crunching.
Must be Horton. Back behind the bush, Professor. We don't want him to catch us here. Don't say anything, Andrew. Keep low. Here comes.
Passed right on by the bush.
How long is it going to take you to get those carcasses buried? All night?
It ain't too easy in the dark. Do better with a lantern.
I told you, no light. Hand me the other spade. I'll help you. Start shoveling.
Kind of like it seems to be putting good meat underground.
How many times must I tell you it isn't good meat?
Poison. Don't look poison.
I say it is. And I'm warning you, shut your mouth about it.
You hear that, Sergeant?
Yes. I'm going to try to sneak back to the house and talk to the girl. You better come with me.
All right.
Keep down and follow the path. But stay off the gravel. I've got a hunch we're going to uncover something tonight.
Yes. Perhaps more than we realize.
Don't worry about us, Julie. We want to help you. Why does your brother keep you locked in the house?
He says it's for my own good. But that's not true. I know why he does it.
Why?
There's something going on. Something he doesn't want me to see. Something that isn't human.
What do you mean, Miss Horton?
I can't explain it, but well, I'm sure he murdered Jeff. I'm sure of it.
There, now. What makes you so sure, Julie?
The night was killed.
Yes, go on.
He sent me into the house. He was out there alone with Kim. It was dark. Pitch dark.
Go ahead, Julie.
I heard their voices. My brother was shouting at Kim. He said he'd kill him if he didn't get off the property.
I think we'd better get her out of here, Sergeant.
No, I can't go. I can't.
Why not, Julie?
He'll follow me. He'll do to me what he did to Jim.
Sergeant, someone's coming. Huh? I hear footsteps on the front porch. Very quick, get her out the back way. Take her to the car and wait for him there. You know where it's back. The county road right at the entrance to the farm.
Yes, yes. Well, come, my dear.
No. No, I'm afraid.
Well, there's nothing to be afraid of. Everything's going to be all right.
Julie. Julie, where are you?
She's gone, Horton.
What are you doing here?
I want to talk to you.
Where's my sister? What have you done with her?
I told you, she's gone.
Where is she? Answer me, where is she?
You don't have to worry, she's safe.
Safe? Safe? Tell me where she is.
Now, Horton, take it easy. She's with Professor Taylor. We're going to take her away from here.
You're going to take her away. You're going to take her away. Over my dead body.
Don't be a fool, Horton. Put that face down. Put it down.
Julie! 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 Sergeant, wake up. You've got to wake up. Terrible things have happened. Sergeant! Please, please wake up. I hate it, I tell you. I hate the critter. It's come from the swamp again.
What happened?
Sergeant, it's me, Andrew. We gotta go after it.
After what?
The critter. I hear it howling for blood.
Where? Where'd you hear it?
Out near the county road.
Good luck. Help me up. Hurry. Are you sure Horton came this way, Andrew?
Yep. I seen him running crazy like. Then I heard the howling, like a wolf howl it was. All it was. Never hit nothing scared me so. Froze my blood.
How much further we have to go?
Gates up ahead. Road just beyond there.
Here. You take the flashlight out. Handle the gun.
Keep looking sharp.
Don't worry.
There's the gate. It's open.
Bring your light.
Yeah.
Wait. Hold it.
Lord to mercy.
What? Professor Taylor. Lying in the road and Horton standing over him. It's all covered with blood. Horton! Horton, get away from him! Get away or let you have it!
No! You got him.
Professor, are you all right?
Yes, I'm all right. Horton!
He's dead.
You're bleeding, Professor. Better get your doctor.
No, wait. Across the road in the bushes near that cypress grove.
What?
Is it?
It's the swamp critter.
Shoot, Sergeant. Shoot into the brush. Don't let it get away.
Nick has got it.
Good.
Come on, Andrew. We'll take a look.
Coming.
Flash your light.
There. In the bushes. Lord mercy. What is it?
It's an animal. With a human face. Must be a werewolf.
Dead, ain't it? Shot through the head.
Sure. Come on back. You were right, Professor. Looks like a werewolf.
That's what it is. It attacked me. Horton fought it off.
What? You mean he had nothing to do with it?
No, but he knew all the time. He'd known for years.
What did he know?
The werewolf was his sister, Julie.